Hello everyone, welcome back to the lecture series on microwave and radar engineering. In this lecture, I am going to teach the 5th unit of the course microwave and radar engineering. Unit 5 is introduction to radar engineering. So in this unit, I am going to discuss the concepts of radar, that is introduction to the radar, radar range equation, pulsed radar, continuous wave radar, FMCW radar, that is frequency modulated continuous wave radar, MTA radar, that is moving target indication radar. So coming to the introduction, the radar is an electromagnetic system for the detection and location of objects. So it operates by transmitting a particular type of waveform, for example a pulse modulated sine wave, and detects the nature of the echo signal. The radar is used to extend the capability of one's senses for observing the environment, especially the sense of vision. Radar cannot resolve detail or color as well as the human eye, that is an optical frequency passive scatter meter. Radar can see in conditions that do not permit the eye to see, such as darkness, haze, rain, and smoke. In addition, the radar has the advantage of being able to measure the distance or range of the object. This is probably its most important attribute, that is, it can measure the range and locate the object. An elementary form of radar consists of transmitting antenna, emitting electromagnetic radiation generated by the oscillator of some sort, a receiving antenna, and an energy detecting device or receiver. A portion of the transmitted signal is intercepted by a reflecting object, that is target, and is re-radiated back in all the directions. So it is the energy re-radiated in the back direction that is of prime interest of the radar. The receiving antenna collects the returned energy and delivers it to a receiver, where it is processed to detect the presence of the target and to extract its location and relative velocity. The distance to the target is determined by measuring the time taken for the radar signal to travel to the target and return back. The direction or angular position of the target may be determined from the direction of arrival of the reflected wavefront or reflected signal. The usual method of measuring the direction of arrival is with narrow beam antennas. If the relative motion exists between the target and the radar, there is a shift in the carrier frequency of the reflected wave. That shift is called Doppler effect, is a measure of target's relative velocity and may be used to distinguish the moving targets from the stationary objects. In radars which continuously track the movement of a target, a continuous indication of the rate of change of target position is also available. The name radar reflects a device to detect the presence of a target and measure its range. So radar is a contraction of the words radio detection and ranging, that is radar, radio detection and ranging. It was first developed as the detection device to warn of the approach of hostile aircraft and for detecting anti-aircraft weapons. So although a well-designed modern radar can usually extract more information from the target signal than merely range, the measurement of range is still one of the radar's most important functions. There seems to be no other competitive techniques which can measure range as well as the rapidly can a radar do it. So what is done by a radar? What is done by the radar? So the radar can see the objects in day or night, rain or shine, land or air, cloud or clutter, fog or frost, earth or planets, stationary or moving objects, and good or bad weathers. In brief, a radar can see the objects hidden anywhere in the globe or planets except hidden behind good conductors. Except the objects hidden behind the good conductors. Okay. Information given by the radar. What information it will give? So the radar gives the following information, that is the position of the object. Main, it is the position of the object. Next one, it is the distance of the objects from the location of the radar. Okay. So nature and types of the radars are, the most common types of radars are speed trap radars, missile tracking radars, early warning radars, airport control radars, navigation radars, astronomy radars, weather forecast radars, tracking radars, identification, friend and foe, synthetic aperture radars, MTA radars, that is moving target indication radars, Navy radars, Doppler radars, mesosphere, stratosphere and troposphere radars, that is simply called as MST radars, monopulse radars, phased array radars, instrumentation radars, airborne weather radars. Okay. So here, what is a radar? So the radar stands for radio detection and ranging. Finally, it is radio detection and ranging. Here, the radar is an object detection system that uses electromagnetic waves to identify the range, altitude, direction, or speed of the both moving and fixed objects such as aircrafts, ships, motor vehicles, weather formations and obstacles like mountains, trees, etc. Okay, basic principles of radar. The basic principle of radars are, so the radars operate on, mainly these are operating on 3000 megahertz to 10,000 megahertz frequency bands. So that will covers super high frequency band, SHF band. Okay. So electromagnetic energy radiating outward from a source and is reflected back by the objects in its path. That is means like the targets. Okay. So the time difference between transmission and reflection. See here, please note that the reflected wave, that means if any target is present in the transmission path, so then the target means which can able to reflect the signals only, those will be targets we are considering here. So here some of the transmitted power will be intercepted by the target and it will be re-radiated back in many directions. So that reflected wave energy will be returned back to the radar, that is called as echo signal. Okay, reflected wave is also called as echoes, is measured giving an accurate indication of an object's distance. Okay, so the distance, azimuth angle and elevation angle can be used to fix the object's position in the three-dimensional coordinates. Okay, the signal timing is critical to accuracy. So 1 microsecond error, 1 microsecond error results in a distance error of almost 500 feet. So as a result, position accuracy is directly related to the accuracy of the timing device used. Okay. So what information the radar can give? So before that, so we'll have the simple block diagram here. So here it is the radar base ground station antenna. Here the parabolic antenna we are using. Okay, parabolic dish antenna we are using. So this is the transmitted pulse transmitted by the parabolic dish antenna. So in this direction, so the transmitted signal will be propagated in the free space. So this is the propagation forward path. And if any object is present, if any target or object is present in that direction, here the target is present. So with the target cross section of sigma, okay, so that transmitted energy is intercepted by the object, that is target. So and it is radiated in many directions. So then the reflected pulse, which is called as echo signal, will be reflected back and it is received by the receiving antenna. Okay, see here, the radar can give the information of target's identity, target range, that is at what distance the target is present from the radar location, and the target height, that is altitude, and target speed in case of the moving objects. So how the radar works? So a radar system, simply it is ground based radar system, has a transmitter that emits radio waves or microwave signals into the free space. So that signal, the signal hit aeroplane or object, so aeroplane or object, and reflected back. Okay, the signal hit the aeroplane or object and reflect back. So the ground based radar picks up that reflected signal during the break transmissions. During the break transmissions, so it will give the some pulse repetition frequency while it is transmitting power. Okay, so next, the time taken for the reflected signal, the time taken for the reflected signal to return back enables a computer to calculate how far the object is, that is called range. Okay, so the aircraft data, the aircraft data then sent and shown on the radar display, right? So the most conventional aircraft have a rounded shapes here that creates that shapes creates a very efficient radar reflector. So means that no matter where the radar signal hits that plane, some of the signals gets reflected back to the radar. Okay, so here it is the illustration of the radar system. So ground station and the transmitting, this green signal will represent the transmitted signal, and this will be hit by the target at some distance of r from the radar. So that transmitted signal intercepted by the object, and the target will re-radiate that energy in all the directions. Some portion of that re-radiated back signal, it is echo signal, is received by the radar receiving antenna and it is further processed. Okay, so radar antenna configurations. So here mainly there are three types of radar antenna configurations. So first one, it is bistatic, next one it is monostatic, and the third one is quasi monostatic. Simple, it is the transmit and receiving antennas. The transmit and receiving antennas are at different locations. So in this bistatic, the transmitting and receiving antennas are at different locations as viewed from the target. As viewed from the target, that is example, ground transmitter and a airborne receiver, somewhere it is. So transmitting antenna and receiving antenna are at different locations which can be viewed from the target. Okay, so coming to the monostatic, the transmitter and receiver, the transmitting and receiving antennas are co-located as viewed from the target. That is, the same antenna is used to transmit and receive the signals. Okay, the same antenna is used for transmitting and receiving the signals. So it is viewed from the target as it is co-located. Okay, so coming to the quasi monostatic, the transmitting and receiving antennas are slightly separated. are slightly separated but still appears to be at the same location as viewed from the target. Example, separate transmitter and receiving antennas are there on the same aircraft. Separate transmitting antenna and separate receiving antennas are there on the same aircraft. Okay, so this is the structure of bistatic. So in this bistatic, so transmitting and receiving antennas are separated, so which can be viewed from the target. Okay, different locations. So ground based transmitting antenna and aeroplane having the receiving antenna. So transmitting signal and received signal, that is reflected signal from the target. So that is bistatic. So coming to the monostatic, so transmitting antenna and receiving antenna is the same for this case. So here it is transmitting signal and receiving signal. So it is in case of monostatic. So coming to the quasi monostatic, see, transmitting antenna and receiving antenna are located on the same aircraft. Okay, so radar functions, so the normal radar functions, so it is, it find the range by using the pulsar delay or pulsar radar and velocity from the Doppler frequency shift that we can measure in the CW radar, and angular direction from the antenna pointing, the direction of the antenna, in which direction the antenna is pointing, angular direction. So from the signature analysis and inverse scattering, so it can also find the target size, that is from magnitude of the return signal. Okay, and target shape and components, so that is based on the return as a function of the direction, this one. Next, moving parts based upon the modulation of the return signal, based on the modulation of the, that is return signal or reflected signal. And next one is material composition also. So radar frequencies, so basically, as I already mentioned, that basically the radars are operating from 3000 megahertz to 10,000 megahertz. So here the radar frequency range of conventional radars, the frequency range of conventional radars from about 200 megahertz to 35 gigahertz. So but there are another specific frequencies at which special radars operate also. Okay, so during the second world war, the letter codes such as LSC, X, etc., the band designations were given to distinguish the frequency bands at which the microwave radar was being developed. So these are developed during the Second World War. Okay, so radar frequency bands. So here already you know that you are already familiar with these bands, LS, CX, KUK, KA band, and a millimeter wave, and as well as UHF band. So from enter this one, it is microwave frequency band. So from UHF to that is millimeter range, 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz range. So these are the frequencies and its wavelength, corresponding wavelengths. So most of the radars are common frequencies used in these bands are this one. Okay, and respective wavelengths. So we'll discuss in detail. So radar frequency bands in this one, high frequency band. So in this, short waves are operating, that is, so based upon that wavelength, it is short waves. So early radars nowadays used for over the horizon distance, that is over the ionospheric propagation. Okay, next, coming to the VHF and UHF, right? So in this VHF and UHF, so these are easy to generate the great transmitting power. So if you are generating the more transmitting power, so these can cover the long ranges. Okay, but ineffectiveness of steel thing techniques, that is large radar cross section. Okay, and you can use it in all the weather conditions also. Okay, next, L band, that is moving target indication radar, will be operated in this L band. Coming to the S band, so it has better angle resolution. Okay, surveillance radar, weather radars are operating in this range. So coming to the surveillance radar, that is long range we are using. Okay, so some attenuation there in case of any rain. C band, so it is smaller lighter devices we are using in this one with comparing with respect to the S bands. Okay, so better resolution with respect to S band and acceptable attenuation in case of rain. So mainly these are used for weather radar, space borne earth observation. And X band, in X band we are having high resolution small and light devices, significant attenuation in case of rain. So it is not really a main thing. Okay, short range surveillance and earth observation can be used, radars used in this X band. So coming to the K bands, that is which includes KU, K and KA band. So these are providing very high resolution in principle, very short range due to rain and path attenuation. Okay, local surveillance radars will be operated in this K bands. Coming to the millimeter wave band, so it is difficult to use due to high attenuation. Okay, so classification of the radars by its functions. Okay, classification of the radar by its functions. So radars are mainly classified into two types: civilian radar, civilian under military purpose. Okay, weather avoidance, navigation and tracking, search and surveillance, high resolution imaging and mapping. These four radars, these four are comes under both civilian as well as military purpose. Okay, so but space flights and sounding radars, these are comes under civilian applications, and proximity fuses, countermeasures, these are comes under military purpose, military applications. Okay, so based on its functions only these are classified, right? So classification of the radars by its waveforms, what are the waveforms we are applying to these radars as a source. Okay, so based on that the classification is, if it is continuous wave radar it will be continuous wave, and if it is pulsed radar, there are two types, pulsed train of the waveform will be there and a continuous waveforms will be given. So pulsed radar as well as continuous wave radar. So in that pulsed radar, again frequency modulated continuous wave radar is there, that is FMCW radar. And in pulsed one, non-coherent and coherent are there. So in the coherent there are three types: low pulse repetition frequency PRF, medium pulse repetition frequency, high pulse repetition frequency. So for low pulse repetition and medium pulse repetition frequencies the MTR radar is used, and medium pulse repetition frequency and high pulse repetition frequency pulse Doppler radar is used. Okay, so these are the classification of the radars with the help of waveforms whatever we are applying to this. Okay, next, types of scan. There are three types: primary scan, secondary scan, Palmer scan. Okay, so what is primary scan? It is a scanning technique where the main antenna aerial is moved to produce a scanning beam. So move to produce a scanning beam. Examples include circular scan, sectoral scan, etc. Okay, so next one, it is secondary scan, a scanning technique where the antenna feed is moved to produce a scanning beam. Examples include conical scan, unidirectional sector scan, lobe switching, etc. Okay, so coming to the Palmer scan, it is a scanning technique that produces a scanning beam by moving the main antenna and its feed. So both main antenna and its feed. So a Palmer scan is a combination of a primary scan and a secondary scan. So these are the references followed for this lecture. Thank you.